I like going hunting, just me, my hound, and my gun. Chasing them deer, rabbit, and squirrel, now that's my kind of fun. I like going fishing too, I'll go on any whim. Looking for the big bass, the crappie, and the brim. Give me a wide open field to walk through. Give me an ocean so deep. I wanna ride the longest river in the world, or maybe climb the highest mountain
down there, Bubba. We got these things rigged up here where we carry tree stands and all with them. They're strapped on here on the back, and this is our little utility thing we rigged up in the back to put all of our pumps and miscellaneous gear that we need. Let's get all that off there, and then we'll get ready to go here. This dog here is one of those standbys. Her name's Sally. She's pretty much a thoroughbred black and tan. Excellent squirrel dog. Tree's hard on the tree. She's got a little bad habit. She likes to run a deer when one comes by. That's the bad part of it. And this one here is kind of a short-eared black and tan. This one we call Blackjack. These are all female dogs. And she might run a deer. We're in deer country down here in Aliceville, Alabama. And there is just an awful lot of deer in here. And for a dog not to run deer, he's got to be a special breeder. You have to just discipline him to the point that he quit doing it. But Blackjack here, the good part, she's a young dog, about 2 years old. And she really likes squirrels better than she does deer. She'll get on one for about maybe 100 yards and then come on back. But now, Sally right here, when she gets on one, it's an all day and all night affair. So we're hopeful we're going to be in there where there's some squirrels. It's not got too many deer coming around. Mark, if you, Bubba, how about you run and picking Jackie up over there, and let's bring her in. Let's get the, so the folks can see the dogs we're using. These dogs, I work with them, these three dogs, I usually hunt them two at a time. I was training this one last year, and she's thoroughly seasoned now and does a good job now. This has always been my main dog here. This is Jackie. She's a blue tick with a little bit of cur in her, and is a real, real good squirrel dog. She's what we call a hot dog. In other words, if that squirrel just popped right up that tree, she don't monkey with none of them. If it's a cold trail or if it's a whatever, she just wants the sure thing. Well, folks, before we start squirrel hunting, a lot of people may want to know what kind of guns you use, and I think that's just a matter of personal choice. Sally's gonna run her mouth right now. We can't talk about it. I use a Model 12 pump and or an automatic, whatever I happen to. I particularly like a pump, and I like, since I have to handle the dogs, I like to have me a strap on it so I can put it on my back. Now, on our three-wheelers, they've got gun racks for their guns, but even then, if I'm riding on the back, I'd rather just put my gun back across my hip there. And with a pump, and of course this may not be gunsmith practice, I always like to give my inside of my gun. I put four cases of shells through this gun this year, and it's a real easy to operate gun. I always like to get a little shot of a WD-40. It's a good idea, this or any other kind of good gun solvent, you ought to carry in your truck with you, because you get down there, if your gun goes to hanging or sticking, just give it a shot of that, and you can generally go on hunting. Otherwise, you're out of business. For the squirrel hunting we're going to be doing down here in Greene County, we'll be using, we don't use low brass on these. Some of these squirrels are in real high timber, and we like a number six shot, high brass. These are Remingtons here. We use Federals. Any of them, it's got a good high brass, and generally number six shot. And that's the type of shells we're going to be using. So we're going to crank up here now. I'll say this about, go ahead, Bo.
Another thing, a lot of people still hunt with a 22. You're going to see here in a minute why we use a shotgun. A lot of people think that that's not real good going with a shotgun, but you're going to see how fast these squirrels move here shortly.
Yeah, in other words, the 22's fine if you happen to tree one and he gets up there and he's up on a limb just sitting there and you can take a 22 and get him. But most of these squirrels, are going. Some of them be in nests, we're going to be jerking vines, and we're going to be thumping around there. When they come out of those trees, they're going to be running real fast. And so unless you're a super-duper 22-shot man, you're not going to get many of them. That's real good for steel hunting. If you park under a big old den tree or something, that'll work good. But we just shotgun folks when we're using dogs, and you'll see why here just shortly. Get him out. All right, let's go. Blackjack came in here just a while ago on this big old den tree here. She's still trailing over to the left, and she give what I call as a cold bark. This tree here probably, it's got, ain't no telling how many squirrels in it. They come down, and then they go around here. Behind us, we got four or five den trees. And then early in the morning, we're a little bit late right now, but early in the morning, you want to catch them away from these den trees and out in them smaller trees where you can get them. But once they come back and hole up in here, it's real tough to get them out of these den trees. But there'll be a lot of those in this little hardwood bottom that we're in. You can see around on the ground where they've been cutting acorns and stuff in there. And Jackie's over there. She's nearly ready to tree on this great big old den tree right here. And if she does, it's going to be tough to get him out of there because he's going to be holed up. There's knot holes all up in it. But maybe she's going to pass. She had a whiff of one, though. It wasn't enough to get her stirred up. Okay, we'll move on down to the next one. Okay, both of the dogs are treed. See Jackie jumping on the tree now. She's saying there's a hot one up that tree right there. And when you see them both treed like that, you're pretty well sure he's there, unless he's topped out maybe. I see the squirrel. There he comes. Many times these, when they leave them den trees, they'll go to another tree, it'll be two or three in the same tree. We always try to make sure that there's none left in the trees. Okay, bring the squirrel on and let's get another one.
Bring it to me, girl. Bring it to me, Jackie. Bring it here, girl. Bring it here. Come on, girl. Bring it here, Jackie. Bring it here, girl. Come on, girl. That's a good girl. Bring it. Whoa now. Bring it. Oh, that's a good girl. Yeah, that's a good girl. Got that old squirrel. There we go. Okay. All right now.
All right.
That's good. All right, let's get another one.
Okay, we believe the squirrel's up in this nest here. Both dogs have treed on it. Jackie originally got it, so we're just going to bust that nest. Go ahead, Mark. No, not in that nest.
He's up there, though.
He's up there somewhere.
He's up there. Y'all look close. That's the logical place for him to be. You don't feel knot holes up there, do you?
We got a hole in the bottom of the tree over here.
You got a hole in it?
Yeah.
Don't
Huh? At the base of the tree?
Huh?
Yeah, that's where it has to be, because that's too little a tree to for him to be in it. We couldn't see. Check it. It's the hole's right down here, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's where your squirrel's at, right here.
Come in here, Blackjack!
Not home. Yeah,
big enough for him to get in.
Well, Jackie's
a star.
Yeah, Jackie's a star. We'll feed him good tonight at supper and put him on the bed. I like to get him a little bit so excited now they want to get back in the woods. They ain't want to do nothing to get back in the woods and hunt.
Well, Mark, it's about that time of the evening here. It's about not nearly 4 o'clock. That's the best time to turn loose for afternoon squirrels. And so, let's just turn loose. We're down here right on Tom Bigby River. Let's let her rip. Okay, come on. Let's go.
Get him up. Get over here. Get over here. Come here, Jackson. Yes. Get over here. Whoa, here. Get over here. Get over here. Get in here. Come on in here, Blackjack. Let's go. Come on in here. Come on in here.
Jackie.
Come on in here, Jackson. Jackson, get in here. Let's go. Come on. Right in here. You see that dog? He's finding you. Get in there. Let's go.
All right, we got him up. It's got a vines going up this tree here, and the dog's treed on it, probably up in that nest up there. We got a good jerk vine. Mark, if you'll give that thing a tug, we'll just see if he comes on out of it. Jerk that vine. He ought to come on out of it. See if we got anything in there. Give it a good jerk. He's not quite getting up there, that vine. You got another vine there, Mark? See if you can get another pull on him there. Try this one on this side right over here. See if you can get a little on there. All right, give it a good little shot right there. That looks good. Jerk it on up there. All right, there he goes. There he goes. Get him, girl. Get him, girl. Wait. All right. Bring here, Jackie. Bring here, girl. Bring here, girl. Bring him here, girl. Bring him, Jackie. Come here, girl. Come here. Come here, Blackjack. Bring him here. Come here. Bring him here. Bring him here. Come on.
Bring him.
Come on, Blackjack. Come on, girl. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Enough.
Okay. Get him on in. Let's go get another one right quick.
Hey. Whoa. Whoa. Whoa now. Whoa, girl. Whoa. Blackjack. Whoa.
You little butter, man.
Here, put him in the bag, Mark. Here. All right, let me show you right here on the ground. Mark, you see all them dug up places? They've been all in there. See, here's pieces of acres. We got a big knot hole right here that's got, y'all just stand by. All right.
When we try the top of that pine?
Yeah, just blast one up in there, see what happens. Maybe he may be up there. I don't know. I think it's his knot hole over here. Go ahead. Shoot him. Come on. Oh, that's a similar squirrel. Get that squirrel there. Hold him. Hold him, Dad. Hold him. All right, get him, Bubba. I believe it's one of them similar squirrels. Get him right quick. Bring him over here.
Yep, get him
over here. Bring him here where we can get him in the light. Let's show him folks what one looks like. Bring him.
Dead.
Right quick.
Dead, come on.
Whoa, dead.
Let's go. Look at that one. Back in. Come on.
Yeah, this one's right. Birdie cinnamon squirrels.
You don't see many of them. Just a few of them down here. Maybe focus in on that right there. See how red he is? He almost looks like he's a fox squirrel, but he's not. He's a gray squirrel with the bottom pigment turned inside out there, and he's red. It's a red squirrel. We call them cinnamon squirrels. They're just native to right down here on the Tom Bigby.
Boy, they've been all down right here.
Boy, in the world, I set my gun.
Right back, right behind you. See it? To your left, straight back.
Oh, wasn't it, Mark? You got a big old hole right there.
You got a hole
right there. Look right here, Mark.
That big old hole right there.
Bubby should have hurried on over here. They was boiling out of that tree before you got here, and the two of them come out of that tree and one out of that, and there's another left in the hole. We got the three of them, but I don't know how many more there was. They were just piling on out of here. The dog treed, and then Jackie came back around. So I believe they're back over here. We're going to get some more. It's getting a little dark now, and it should get red hot for the next 15, 20 minutes. So let's get on.
Okay.
He's up in there, but he's away up in there. All right.
Go!
Stand by. Get him on up. I'm going to shoot up in here again, Marky. Right. We may rush him out of here. He's up in there tight for you. Okay, get him up real
quick. Get in here! You get in here! You get in here! Come into me! Come into me! You come to me. Get in here. Get in here. Come on in here.
Jackie,
get in here. Come on in here.
Folks, we interrupt this program to bring you a special outdoor bulletin. Well, folks, we got a world record fish right down here at Keith's Hardware. They got them down to let folks see him. A lot of folks ain't never seen a world record fish. Joe Lamoro here is the catcher, and Tim is his brother. He's the one that tied the jigs for him that are for sale right down here at Keith's, and that's the one that caught him on right there. These boys from
Grub and Rubber.
Yeah, Grub and Rubber. That's the name of the jig, and y'all were basically crappie fishing, weren't you?
That's right.
Now, you know, that's a surprise of a lifetime, be out there fishing around a treetop, and an old big blue cat come running out there. Tim, you've been over there a while, aren't you?
That's right.
And I think y'all's all raised over there, and you just tie these things now.
That's correct.
And then you the field tester, isn't that right?
That's correct.
Well, now tell me what happened, Joe, and where you's at. Let's put the fish back in the hole right there, and then y'all folks can see that is a big fish, for sure. 46-pound, 0.8 hundredths. And it is a fine blue. Where was y'all at fishing now?
We was on Lay Lay.
Lay Lay.
On the lower end, close proximity to Paint Creek.
I see. Were you in a treetop?
No, we was fishing a rocky shoal there that was about 20 foot deep.
Uh-huh.
Buddy that was with me caught a 4.5-pound hybrid just prior to that.
On the same deal?
On the same jig.
Now, was that'll get hybrids and all, huh?
I've caught a 7.5-pound smallmouth on that jig, and I've caught a 30-pound blue. And a bunch of big spots, 5-pound, 10-pound.
The spotted bass like it pretty good,
yes,
huh?
Sir. That's primarily spots and smallmouth is number one on that.
What about crappies?
I've caught boxes full.
Just, in other words, when you're out there in the treetop or a deep bluff where they're sitting on, you just liable to catch anything
once
with it.
Once you locate the depth and the color,
you ready
catch
to get
the fish.
Catch
the
fish.
Get it in the strike zone. That's what counts.
Well, what did you think happened when this thing picked it up? Did you pick it up like a bass, or how did he do?
I thought I had a hybrid.
Thought you had a hybrid. Uh-huh.
I took out. I knew it was a big fish right after I stuck him. He made one trip around the boat. Made another trip around the boat, and I got him up. Saw what it was then.
Well, this little 12-pound test line.
Well, that's 10-pound string.
10-pound string.
But it would go into a 12-pound class. They don't have a 10-pound class in IGFA.
I see. And you're using this loose open face? Is this what you're using?
So that speed spin too with that Tennessee handle loose light action open face rod.
Well, that goes to show, Joe, that you don't have to have a deep sea rod to catch a big old fish, don't it?
Well, this is the biggest fish I ever caught in my life, and I've caught, like I said, a bunch of fish on that. That's a number one wire hook in that jig right there. And you just set your drag to your hook, you can catch them.
You can catch them, as long as he don't run through a tree.
That's right.
If he runs through a tree, it's all over.
You got him in open water, you got it made.
Yeah.
And I was scared to death I was going to get wrapped up in a trot line or a piece of trash.
Well, did you try to move the boat out, or did you just stay with him?
Well, my brother was operating a trolling motor.
What'd you think, Tim?
I knew it was something big, you know what.
Boy, that was a fine squirrel hunt out there today. I sure did enjoy that. And looked like we might not have limited out, but we limited out and having fun out there. And Chris, I've been hearing you coming around there at the shop humming and singing these rhymes and all, and I heard a line you played the other day, and you finished that thing up called Sportsman's Dreams, all about us boys enjoy hunting and fishing here in Alabama. You want to hit a lick on that and tell us about it?
Well, like I said,
come
it's forced
Sally.
The stream.
Come on,
and it's just rope for all these hunters and fishers. And just outdoors type people. It goes like this. Chasing them deer, rabbits, and squirrel, that's my kind of fun. I like going fishing too, I'll go on any whim. Looking for the big bass, the crappie, and the brim. Just give me a wide open field to walk through. Give me an ocean so deep. I wanna ride the longest river in the world, or maybe climb the highest mountain peak.
Look at her, she likes
it. Look at it.
I like four-wheel riding, slipping and sliding over hill and dale, singing hip hooray, come on, this place, life I love so well. I like going down to the fishing hole, my buddies and me and my old cane pole, bait them hooks and wet them lights, a life I love so fine, and it's almost a good time, you'd think the world was mine. Just give me a wide open field to walk through. Give me an ocean so deep. I wanna ride the longest river in the world, or maybe climb the highest mountain
You see old Sally, she enjoyed that too.
Yeah, well, she didn't howl, did she?
She didn't howl the same week. She wanted to say,
well, that's super good. Now, boys, we've had a good day, and we need to get our gear all cleaned up, and we can go on and shack up for the night here, and then we'll be ready to go again in the morning. I believe these dogs are running enough now where they about ready to take it in for the night, and we'll get out bright and early in the morning and enjoy some more good old hunting in the great outdoors. I want all you folks out there in Alabama to join in with us on WDBB every Saturday evening. We're going to be hunting and fishing and doing all kinds of the great stuff we have in Alabama. And, you know, the good Lord knew what he did when he built the state of Alabama for the outdoor folks, because we got the finest place in the world. And we're going to take y'all, hope y'all enjoy the experiences that we enjoy in the outdoors here in Alabama.